So good morning, sorry. Good morning, students. Last class we discussed about shear force and bending moment diagram, and where we get maximum bending moment, and where we may get minimum bending moment. These are the things we discussed in the last class. Where shear force or bending moment, the sign conversion will be placed on the diagram. At that point, we called as point of contraflexion. Up to this, we discussed in the last class. Today, we are going to see just a brief summarized one problem. After that, we'll move for testing of materials by using universal testing machine. So now I'm going to share my screen to you. See, this is the problem they asked in GATE ME 92 here. See, a large uniform plate containing rivet hole is subjected to uniform uniaxial tension of 95 MPa. The maximum stress in the plate is, so here we need to calculate maximum stress. There is a one plate having a length of 10 centimeters, height of 10 centimeters, and left side it is acting 95 MPa, and right side it is acting, some amount of force is not given. But we need to calculate how much amount of stress induced in that plate material. For that, we need to solve the problem. For in the case, the maximum stress developed in the material develops across the rivet hole, let P be the axial tensile force. So in that problem, this is a plate, they are having a hole here, and both sides some amount of force is acting. So this side they has given as 95, this side is not given. So I'm going to make equilibrium for that both condition. Let us assuming that this body in equilibrium, so that I'm equating the forces right side and left side. So first, this side stress induced in the plate. So 95. So what is the formula for stress? Stress is equal to load by area. So I want to know the what is the load acting on the member. See this in the problem. Uniaxial tension of 95 MPa. They given a tension as 95 MPa. So 95 into thickness into 10. This yield gives area. This is about uniaxial tension and tensile stress. So that is equal to sigma into T into 10 minus 5. What is mean by 10 minus 5 here? What is mean by 10 minus 5? Let's go once again, go back to the problem. This total length of the plate equal to 10. There is some amount of material is deducted from the plate, that is 5 centimeters. So I use 10 minus 5. From that, sigma is equal to, so here I'm going to get cancel T, T. Then sigma is equal to, we are getting this equation into this side. So 95, 10 minus 5, it will give 5. So I am getting this side, it will come by 10 by 5. 95 into 10 by 5. So by simplifying this, I will get 190 megapascal. So I'm equating the equations. Just I'm equating the equation, and I will find unknown values from the problem. So this is the procedure we follow for calculating of this type of problems. Then, what is the best way to predict the future is to create it. So what is that? Whatever you creating in the future, in what way you are going to predicate that equipment or something material? So this is the best way, in what way we are going to predicate. Let us see. Here, elastic limit of cast iron as compared to ultimate breaking strength is. Elastic limit and ultimate breaking strength is equal to 1. So let us take the stress strain curve. This is the elastic curve. So here the stress strain curve plot for that cast iron material. This is the E is the breaking point. D is the ultimate stress point. C is the lower yield point. See, this is the diagram. In the diagram, I'm taking the strain in y x-axis, stress in y axis. So here, this is the stress strain curve I plotted here. So here up to A, at point A we call as a maximum elastic limit point, B is the yield point, C is the lower yield point, D is the ultimate stress point, E is the break or rupture point. So for cast iron material, elastic limit by ultimate break strength is equal to 1. Why I'm telling that? In a cast iron, iron material, elastic limit by ultimate strength is equal to 1 means the ratio of both this is used to only 1. See, let's see that. So, it's equal to 1. So, elastic limit of cast iron compared to ultimate breaking strength is 10. So, what is the answer here? Approximately. So next question. In tensile test, near the elastic limit zone, near the elastic limit zone, so tensile stress increases at faster rate. Tensile stress decreases at the faster rate. Tensile stress increases proportion to the stress. Tensile stress decreases linear proportion to the shear stress. So let us take, this is the diagram. So this one, this is the elastic region. Elastic limit. So you see that at near elastic limit, the cross-section area of the material start to decrease the tensile stress. So cross-section is going to decrease. So then stress decrease at faster rates when after it reaching the elastic limit. So correct answer. Idealized the stress strain curve for a perfectly plastic material is given by. So in the last class we discussed about this. these are the diagrams are given that this way which one is correct material. So equals to stress is directly proportional to strain at the elastic region. So here there is no elastic limit. We are not obeying the equation. So we have one is linear elastic plastic material. So there is a elastic resisting limit. It is the plastic limit. Elastic plastic material. So elastic are perfectly plastic. So here mein, there is a elastic limit, plastic stress. So rigid and linear hardening material. So this is the stress of the rigid linear hardening material. Next, rigid perfectly plastic material. So there is no elastic region in there. That is the strain curve. So this is that the plastic stress. So answer is A. Correct answer. So next question. The stress strain curve of an ideal elastic strain hardening material will be as. So this strain curve, an ideal elastic strain and hardening material will be as. So this is ideal elastic strain hardening. So the curve which we for this material, for this stage we need to identify the material. So let's see that I'll still carry my stress strain curve dekhna. So stress strain curve. Here is the region and after that chain hardening and neck tangle starts. Stress strain is going to be D. So answer is correct answer. Which of the following material generally exhibit yield point? So cast iron, annealed and hot rolled mild steel, soft brass, or cold steel. We need to know that yield point and then. So this is the stress strain curve. Solid load at which solid material that is being to stretched and willing to change the shape permanently. So after elastic region, which place will start to permanently. So after this limit, yield point. So cast iron. Cast iron is a high carbon silicon content. It is brittle material. It generally happened at yield point. Wrong answer. So cast iron is wrong option. Annealed and hot rolled mild steel. So it exhibits the rest of mild steel ductile material. Temperature is going to increasing to along to close to is called annealed. Hot rolled previous question temperature. Mild steel. So mild steel ductile material. So it is the answer, correct answer. Soft brass, pure ductile material. And cold rolled is pure brittle material. It's a pure brittle material. So you need to choose the answer from these two. Daughters. And option C. We have confusion with option B and option C. So which one is correct answer? And materials. So in the problem. Which of the poly material generally exhibits yield point? the stress strain and compress material is like this. So answer is this soft bars. Then after that it is rapidly going to, let us see that this is going to regularly increasing compared to the spare. This point will be elastic region. So some brass have no yield point. And hot rolled mild steel. So that means it has the yield point. The correct answer. So we need to match the list 1 and list 2. It is given for 2 marks question. So here, types of test and materials, and list 2 cast iron, types of field fractures, tensile test and cast iron, cast iron. So when you are doing performing the tensile test and cast iron material, the failure will happen, sudden failure, granular fracture. So match color, it is going to match with second one. So are going to match with second one. Okay. Correct, sorry. So the answer is correct, the answer is 5, because of it is a granular helicoid fracture, but it is a transverse plane. So A to 5. So torsion on mild steel. Torsion test on mild steel. So torsion test steel. But we are going to give steel. So steel G is it is a carbon dioxide 0.05 to 0.25 carbon. So you give this granular and helicoidal fracture. So this one is correct answer. B2. So it is creating helical shape, that's why it called as helicoidal fracture. Next is 2. B is matched with 2. Next, tensile test on mild steel. Mild steel. It generates a cup and cone shape. It generates cup and cone shape. Cone shape. So answer is 4. Answer 4. C is matched with 4. Next, tensile test on cast iron. So once again the same thing as asked. It. It is a brittle material, so it is greater than 2% of carbon content in the materials. Then no, the torsion equal to twisting moment applied at the end of both ends. So it is going to shear. So here plane gradual at 45 degrees to axis. So D match with 3. So correct answer 5 to 4 3 is the correct answer. For most brittle material, the ultimate strength compression is much greater than the ultimate strength in the tension. In tension, the main due to presence of brittle metal with compression load, high ultimate strength as compared to the in tension tests. So the presence of flux. Correct answer. Full tension length of 401.2 mm. So by applying the tensile load on 330 MPa, it defines the elastic response. Megapascals. So with actually megapascals. Elastic things more or less is copper is identified. So we are going to the stress curve. That problem. So change in length by original length. By length of the specimen. Okay. It's equal to load by area. Strain. So x change. That is equal to 330 megapascal, 330 by, so area is not given, so we'll keep A as a. So it is going to consider the unit area, so it is gives stress equal to 330 megapascals. Mm square. So is equal to 30 by strain equal to this. So strain is equal to 3 to 10 power 3. So E is equal to 330 by 3 into 10 power 3 equals 1 into 1.10 power 10 power mm square. So in answer, equal to 110 gigapascal. A is the correct one. Correct answer. If the following properties more sensitive to increase the strain rate, which property is more acting under increasing the sensitivity in the strain rate? So yield strength, proportional limit, elastic limit, tensile strength. So in that curve, stress strain curve. So here the question is, which of the following property is more sensitive to increase the strain rate? So which property, yield strength or proportional limit, elastic limit and tensile strength? So here in this diagram, up to this we called elastic limit. This is upper yield point, it is a lower yield point, and this is the ultimate stress point, and this is the fracture or breaking point. So generally failure will starts at after the elastic limit region only. So after elastic limit, this is the elastic limit region. So in that problem, more sensitivity increase in the strain rate. So strain rate without giving the any load, that will going to continuously deform. So in, within, what is the cause for giving, like, doing this? Quick decrease or respond, slight changes. Stress is equal to strain. So stress is more, stress is also more. So quick right, proportional limit is the correct answer. Strain. So stress is the sensitive parameter here. So proportional limitation limit is the more sensitive parameter in increasing to the strain. So is the correct option B is the correct answer. So in this we need to match the materials with the stress, with the stress strain curve, stress strain curves. So first mild strain. So option three. So option is three. So option three is the correct answer for that first one. So the pure copper. So pure copper ductile material, but copper not will happen. So B is equal to 2 for copper metal. There is no yield point. Then cast iron. So in that cast iron is the brittle material. So there is no fracture. Direct it have to fracture. No yield point. So 4 is the answer. 4. Next, pure aluminum is the 1. It's a 1. No, so this is equal to 1. Aluminum stress strain diagram and the copper stress strain diagram, because of it have a yield point, because of these three also ductile materials. Just so this problem is asked in that previous paper. While tested in the tension fracture in a universal testing machine, which of the steel so it is being tested on tensile test testing machine. So which of the following mechanical properties of material can be evaluated? Mechanical properties of the material can be evaluated from the test. First, so when I'm performing the first, this modulus of elasticity. Second, first step in the first, see 1 minute. So it's a stand curve. So first one is elastic limit, then yield test. So correct. So ductility, we are not going to testing machine with after fracture. So tensile strain strength. So to tensile, so it will going to calculate the tensile strength. Correct. So modulus of rigidity. So nothing of rigidity. Yes, it is going to calculate let us see. So UTM. So that means 1, 2, 3, 4 is the correct answer. So D is the correct answer. A mild stainless steel, D is 10 mm. So ductile material, mild steel is a ductile material. Elastic modulus is 2 into 10 power. So E is equal to 2 into 500 newtons. Load is applied is equal to 50,000 newtons. Taking a just beyond the yield point. So regarding this point, the elastic limit. So the elastic recovery of strain. The elastic recovery of strain. What upon removal tensile load will be. You see, there is a equation. So strain material. So we need to calculate strain of the material. So we know stress is relation to strain. Stress is equal to in small less equal to strain. So we can write strain is equal to stress by stress. So this is a formula we are need to use. This is given. Just substitute the values in that equation. So strain is equal to strain equal to. So we substitute that value, we will get the answer 3.18 into 10 power minus 3 is the correct answer. Hooke's law is valid up to elastic limit. Ultimate stress, breaking point. So stress is direct relation to strain. So stress up to elastic limit proportion. Yeah. So answer is limit of proportional stress. So in this problem, what is the safe tensile load M36 4C bolt mild steel having yield stress of 28 megapascal and factor of safety is 1.4. so there is a confusion here. M36 4C is the designation as given for that problem. So in that M36 4C, the diameter is nominal diameter of the bolt material is 36 and 4C is the property of the class. So for that we need to calculate static tensile load for that material. They're given as the factor of safety is equal to 1.5. so now so diameter 36 we already seen. So factor is equal to 1.5. so FS is equal to 1.5. so here we could find safe elastic tensile load. So nothing but PS is equal to P safety factor is equal to find it. So first we need to calculate yield stress is equal to force by area acting on the specimen. So P equal to strength to area. So yield stress is equal to is given at 280 megapascal. So yield stress has given as a 280 megapascal here. So is equal to 280 P by safety. So this is sigma y by area by factor of safety. So 280 pascal into pi by 4 d square. Pi by 4 d square by into 4 by is given as 1.5. So by simplifying this we will get, so we substitute 288 into pi into 36 square by 1.5 into 4. So that gives us 190 kilonewtons. So answer B is the correct answer. Correct answer. So in that we seen what are the problems generally they asked in that for that material proper testing of materials under UTM machine. So they majorly concentrate on that tensile stress curve. So where the stress strain curve is will be changes the shape. So yield point, elastic limit, upper point and lower point and fracture point. Similarly, in that previous question paper, he asked many problems on different types of curves for the different materials. If you remind these curves for the different material, you will correctly answer for 2 marks question. And it is asking basically basic stress strain problems on the particular things. So like that, we need to solve the problems in your for this unit. So next we'll see this in this video also. We'll see what are the problems we got in the previous GATE question papers. So here, same here also they ask you select the purpose of sequence: proportional limit, elastic limit, yielding limit, and failure. So stress curve. So first is proportional limit, well, elastic limit, then yield point and rupture point. So here yield point and ultimate strength and rupture strength here, failure strength. So now given question, it is that 1 2 1 2 3 4, then yielding and then failure. So answer is correct answer. So sustain karu mild steel, the ultimate tensile strength refers to tensile karu mild steel, ultimate tensile strength refers to. So we'll calculate at yield stress, proportional limit, maximum stress, fracture stress. So we will get here. So here we'll get 0.05 to 0.25% carbon percentage there in the material. So ductile material strength curve for the ductile material. So here ultimate strength is tensile strength. So stress maximum. So answer is maximum stress is the correct answer. Stress is the correct answer. So elastic modulus of rigid perfectly plastic solid is. So plastic material is equal to stress by strain. Rigid perfect plastic solid. So stress is equal to zero. So strain is equal to modulus equal to stress by is equal to. So it gives answer infinity. The infinity. So 1/0 is equal to infinity. So answer is infinity. Rigid here in this problem that we will get rigid perfect plastic solid. So here that getting that perfectly plastic. So not there is no strain. So keep zero. Tensile stress is beyond the yield point. Then unload strength specimen. So applying both sides. Yield point. Apparent yield point. Straightly beyond the yield point. Unloaded. So it is going to decrease. Yield decrease, increase, become equal. Maximum strength develop deformation. Stress is strength. Strain high hardening. So in that case, so strain are going to see increase. So option B is the correct answer. So the percentage of elongation of material as obtained from the static tension test depend upon that. So the question is the percentage of elongation of material, percentage of elongation of material as obtained from static tension test depend upon that. So here, so this is that ETM machine. So here there are two jars, jar 1 and jar 2. So specimen will put in between these two jars and we are applying the load. So what will happen? The percentage of elongation of material is obtained from the static tensile test depends upon that. Diameter of the test specimen, gauge length of the test specimen, nature of end grips of the testing specimen, and geometry of the test specimen. So we'll see. Obtained from the static tension test depends upon the diameter. So we have a formula. Percentage of elongation is equal to so minus original length, divided by total length, final length. We'll calculate by using these formula. Specimen with independent length of the specimen. So gauge length nothing but here to here. Nature of end grips is the testing machine. So which grips you are using here? So that nature, geometry of the test specimen. This is the test machine. So geometry of the test. So answer is test. So we take the percentage of specimen. Gauge length is equal to this one. Gauge length is elongation depend upon. So answer is gauge length of the specimen. So because of elongation formula, total depend on the length. Stress strain relationship best describe the behavior of the brittle material. Brittle material such as ceramics, thermoset, and glass. So D is the correct answer. So here, brittle materials, yes, and thermosetting plastics. So remind that ceramics and thermosetting plastics are brittle materials. So D is the answer. Nature, moderately ductile material, elongation. So brittle material, see here. So material is without deformation. So delta L is equal to 0. So the value of strain is very low. So D is the correct answer. So it is the correct answer. More compared to this. This is also very high. So D is the very low strain curve. So the next question is, the strain hardening exponent n of the stainless steel 304 with a distinct yield UTS value undergoing the plastic deformation. With a distinct yield ultimate tensile strength values undergoing plastic deformation is. So that values, that is, so strain hardening, so strengthening the metal by plastic deformation is called strain hardening. So plastic deformation, strain hardening. So strain hardening is equal to something to whole to the power of n. So wherein is called a strain hardening exponent. Strain hardening index. K equal to strength quotient and rho is stress, sigma is equal to stress, n is equal to proportion, is lying between 0 to 1. So option C is, answer is C. using universal testing machine, the parameter actually really measured. True stress testing machine. If they're asking the specimen using invisible parameters actually measuring. So true stress and true strain. Option B, Poisson's ratio and Young's modulus. Option 3, engineering stress and engineering strain. D, load and elongation. So we are going to directly measure load and elongation. We'll calculate load and elongation. So option D is the correct answer. Material highly elastic. So rubber, brass, steel, glass. So following the material is high elastic. See, steel. Correct material for high elastic. So applying the load on the steel material, remove the load. Steel with so answer is steel. Steel material is the correct answer. Steel is the correct answer. So now we seen that things. What are the problems we are generally getting in that gate question paper when engineering stress and strain, how that materials are going to test in UTM, what are the questions generally asked in the previous gate question paper we seen till now. So for today's, that's all for today's class. Thank you, my students.